Hi guys, welcome to Heartlight Tarot and Astrology. This is going to be a love reading for the sign of Pisces for the first half of March. If you're a returning viewer, welcome back. If you're new to my channel, I work with tarot and the energy of the tarot along with what's going on astrologically to give you guys a predictive forecast. So if that's something that you guys are interested in, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell. I post bi-weekly general, bi-weekly love readings, and this month's special reading is Lunar Eclipse in Libra. And if you want to know, if you're here for relationships, obviously you are. If you're here for love, obviously you are. This lunar eclipse is going to be changing relationships on a whole new level. So don't forget to hit that notification bell so you can hear how it possibly is changing your relationships. Okay. This is not a personal reading. This is not a one-to-one reading. This is just a collective for the sign of Pisces, sun, moon, and rising. Pay attention to your moon sign this month, considering the lunar eclipse is going to be affecting, everyone's moon signs because, you know, it's lunar. So, yeah, so I'm going to get you guys your astrology a little bit about what might be going on in your relationships in regards to astrology. So March 3rd, Venus is in Aquarius. Aquarius rules your 12th house of, you know, behind the scenes, subconscious thoughts and patterns and habits and addictions and hospitals and maybe some kind of, you know, deep therapy work that you're going through, or it could be, you know, your self undoing habits. So, you know, Venus has been in there. It's in there. Okay. And it's squaring Taurus in your third house of, you know, the way that you communicate. So there might be shakeups in the way that you communicate, the way that you think, the relationship to your siblings or short distance travel. There might be shakeups in something, you know, in regarding to your travel, short distances, relationships to your neighbors. So maybe that those two things might be colliding. Okay. And Venus being in your 12th house, it's really making you think about, you know, the habits that you have in relationships that could be possible. It can make you feel like maybe that you want to be more of a free spirit rather than being committed to somebody. But it's squaring Taurus, it's squaring Uranus and Taurus is ruled by Venus. So the fact that it's opposing each other, you might just be thinking about what type of relationship you really truly want to have, and helping you to kind of work through some things subconsciously and what kind of relationship you want to have in general. Okay. On the 9th, Mars enters the same transit. So Mars is going to be squaring Uranus and Taurus and it's going to be in your 12th house. So it may make you feel like you want to take action on these thoughts. It may make you feel like you really want to tell somebody or, you know, fight for something that's really bothering you, but that you didn't realize was bothering you. Okay. It might all come to light. Mercury enters Aries that day. So you might feel like you're very, outspoken in regards to what it is that you want in a relationship, what is you can handle, maybe sharing some kind of secret with somebody about, you know, some habits that you have, some addictions that you have, or they might be sharing those with you. On the 11th, Venus enters your sign, Pisces, your first house of, you know, the way that the world sees you, the way that you see the world, your philosophy on life, right? Your the way you show up in the world, okay, just all about you. Can, you know, Venus entering it, you could be finding love for the first time. You could be falling in love for the first time. It's very much possible. You could be meeting the love of your life for the first time around that time, okay? Or you might just be falling in love with yourself. The self-love could really like enhance at that time. For your tarot card, we got the Knight of Wands, clarified with the Queen of Pentacles. So I feel like you're going to be taking a lot of action in regards to, you know, becoming stable. All right, there's somebody that you want to have fun with, somebody that you feel excited about, somebody that you want to run towards, okay? But you also, you know, you feel both. You feel like you want to run to this person, take adventures with this person, maybe not take things so seriously, but at the same time, you want to take things seriously. So you're like giddy, and I feel like butterflies right now. I feel like a lot of butterflies for you. This person makes you crazy, but it makes you, they want, they, they make you want to wife them, or like make them your husband, or become their wife, or they want you to, they make you want to be everything for them. Okay. They spark up so much excitement in you. All right. I'm going to get you guys a love oracle card for the sign of Pisces. Oh, that one flew out. Hand of cards, take a chance, risk, be strategic, options, not showing your hand and gambling. I feel like this person makes you want to run towards them, but at the same time, you're going to be strategic instead. You're going to take a chance and you're going to go forward with this person and move forward with this person, but you're also going to keep an eye on your options. Okay. You're not going to show them the whole you. Okay. Because really behind the scenes, you might just be working on your stability, in hopes that this relationship works out, but just in case it doesn't, you'll be a stronger person anyways. Okay. So it's kind of like, I'm kind of get this feeling where it's like, you see somebody that you want to run towards and you think it could work, and you start to kind of better yourself in a way where you're just like, okay, I know I'm ready for a relationship, but I'm going to keep bettering myself for myself first and them second, because if this doesn't work out, then at least I know I'm taking better moves for myself. And I feel like it's a very, very Pisces way of thinking. Cause you're always thinking ahead, right? You guys are very smart. I got stay optimistic, positive thinking, and faith will bring romance into your life. So yeah, I feel like whatever it is that you're doing, the Knight of Wands, he loves to travel and he makes fun out of everything, right? He goes places and he's involved with things, and he's a very action-oriented sign. He doesn't necessarily know where he's going, but he stays optimistic, right? He's positive thinking anyway. So this is perfect energy. What this is saying is that it doesn't matter if this person works out for you or not, you know that your love is right around the corner. Okay. But you're deciding not to show all your cards yet, because you know you deserve, Pisces. Okay. It's very positive energy. Stay optimistic. Love is right around the corner. And I wish you all the best of luck. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you guys catch my special readings for you guys and all the other readings that I post throughout the month. And I'll see you guys again soon. Bye.